You know what I think New World has failed to add in? I think New World has forgot to add in the fun bit. Their crafting is really complicated and it's decent, but it's mechanical. It's extremely mechanical. There's no real heart behind it. There's no joke. Like sometimes in Final Fantasy XIV, some of the items have stupid descriptions. They have joke descriptions. In RuneScape doesn't take itself seriously. The Elder Scrolls Online has an entire plot about having two NPCs trying to hook up with each other. I feel that what New World has done is it's taken itself super seriously. It literally is a corporate MMO. It's what would happen if you took a load of people who don't play MMORPGs, told them how an MMO is meant to work, and then made them take it really seriously. You know what there isn't in New World? There isn't a raid finder or a dungeon finder. As much as I dislike them, a lot of people want them. And it would help. I also think there should be more to do before level 60. I am not a fan of the content beginning at end game. I think that is the dumbest thing you can possibly do. To have the content begin at end game, you're basically telling me your entire previous game is contentless. There should be stuff to do all the way through. Getting to level 60 should not be, okay, now the game starts. It should be, oh, fantastic, now you've got access to a few more things. RuneScape does it the best. RuneScape and Guild Wars 2 do it exceptionally well. Just play the game, you unlock stuff as you go. It's difficult to have content before end game. I mean, not really. You just add in stuff that matters at that point. If I were to ever make an MMORPG, you would be able to do basically everything in the game at level 1, a version of it, and then as you level, you just unlock more complex stuff of what you've already got. I truly believe, and forget me if I'm wrong, at level 1, you should have access to a quest line. You should also have access to crafting. You should have access to gathering. You should have access to a dungeon-style experience. You start an MMO. You are level 1. You are a player who likes dungeons. Well, that's just pretty good, because guess what? Your first dungeon, literally training. It's a dungeon set in a castle training yard through an assault course set up for you with castle guards fighting against you, and you have to find three or four other people to do it, and there's a dungeon finder. If that's all you want to do, cool, there you go. That is the experience for you to have, right there. And once you've done that, there'll be more and more and more. Consider this, and this is going to sound dumb, but consider this. Imagine you made an MMORPG, and the only way that you could possibly level from start of the game to end of the game is just dungeons. You've got dungeon at level 1, dungeon level 2, dungeon level 3, dungeon level 4, dungeon level 5, and by the time you get to whatever the maximum is, you know, 50, you can get to 50 by just playing all the dungeons. Now imagine another MMO where you can get to the max level by just crafting, just gathering, just following the main quest line. What about just following the side quest lines? So you've got all these games where you can get to maximum by just following the route that you want to follow, but the other routes are there for you. And now imagine you put all of these together. So when you join in to your MMO, there's a dungeon available to you, but there's also gathering, there's also crafting, there's a main storyline, there's a side storyline. There's a bit of open world PvP. There's a bit of this. There's a bit of that. You choose what you want to go and do with that, and it's always open to you, and it's super easy to access. All of the successful MMOs do that. You can just go through FF14 like that. You can just go through Elder Scrolls like that. It's not sandbox. People say that's called sandbox. No, it's not. It's theme park, because you literally have things open to you that you then go and do. Sandbox is there is nothing set. Make your own fun. There are no dungeons, there's no quests, there's no storylines, there's nothing that you do. It's just, here you go, we've built a world with nothing in it, go and enjoy it. And sometimes that works, but theme park MMOs are where you actually have stuff to do.